When Sir Joe Bjelke-Petersen resigned his Premier's position in the late 1980s, Queensland's political system was left in disarray. Now, Cabinet papers from the time 1988 have been released, and they've revealed how MPs dealt with the fallout of Sir Joe's reign and his attempt to win back the trust of Queenslanders. Here's state political reporter Alison Horne.
It was the year Queensland announced itself on the world stage.
3, 2, 1.
Expo 88 captured the hearts and imaginations of 15 million visitors, including international dignitaries.
Mrs. Thatcher reluctantly touched the reptile, no doubt encouraged by the animal's taped-up mouth.
But before Expo was over, Cabinet was grappling with the future of the South Bank site. Without any consultation, it approved a private development for the area, including an artificial island in the Brisbane River for a World Trade Centre. Cabinet documents show there was massive public backlash, so the approval was withdrawn.
The government has made that decision that there will not be a casino on the site, and that's a definite decision.
The government had to forfeit $150 million of taxpayer money, but in the process, it guaranteed public parkland for future generations.
And the development that's there cost Brisbane, Queensland nothing except $150 million, which I wrote off with this hand.
Mike Ahern came to the top job in Queensland at the end of 1987 when Sir Joe Bjelke-Petersen resigned amid corruption controversy.
Goodbye and God bless.
Confidence in government was broken with allegations of widespread bribery. So the Premier's first Cabinet decision of 1988 was to establish a public accounts committee that's still in place today.
Premier Ahern held his ministers to account by tabling their ministerial expenses in Parliament where they could be scrutinised. Three of Premier Ahern's ministers were imprisoned for misappropriating public monies.
But the Nationals leader clashed with his Cabinet over the ongoing Fitzgerald Inquiry and his decision to widen the terms of reference to outside the police force.
And they're all looking at me silently, not liking it. But these things had to be done. And they were necessary to be done as soon as possible.
He made further enemies when his Cabinet agreed to block the pension for disgraced former Police Commissioner Terry Lewis. Lewis later spent a decade in jail for taking $700,000 in bribes.
History shows Mr. Ahern's Cabinet got their decision in relation to Lewis right.
Corruption in Queensland's prisons was also investigated when Cabinet approved a wide-sweeping inquiry. Third world conditions were exposed at the Boggo Road jail.
There was still an entire block of prisoners at Boggo Road in 1988 who were using buckets for toileting overnight because there was no plumbing to the cells.
And corrections staff clashed with the government over the inquiry, some even helping five prisoners escape the notorious jail. A year later, Boggo Road was shut down. The documents also reveal a surprising amount of time and money was spent trying to block a bid to list North Queensland's forests on the World Heritage Register. Government delegations were sent overseas as protests raged at home. But the government lost, and in late 1988, the Wet Tropics World Heritage Area was declared. Mike Ahern's reign in 1988 was wedged between two powerful eras in Queensland politics, Sir Joe and Wayne Goss. But these documents prove his Cabinet made dozens of decisions to increase accountability and transparency, setting the tone for future politics. But Mr. Ahern's hard line did not satisfy his party, who overthrew him just 2 months before the 1989 election. Those accounts will be released next year. Alison Horne, ABC News, Brisbane.